Okay. Okay, welcome everybody to this webinar. I'm Steven Say. I'm from the MediaTek Labs. MediaTek Labs is a developer-centric ecosystem. We help developers worldwide in their wearable and IoT development. I'm the technical lead of a global team for the technical support for those developers who are interested in using MediaTek platforms in their wearable and IoT development. Without further ado, I'm going to continue to our presentation. Today, we are going to cover the following topics. What is LinkIt? LinkIt ONE is our first release of LinkIt platform. We have LinkIt ONE HDK, it's a hardware developer kit. And also we have LinkIt ONE SDK, it's a software development kit. And also we will go through some examples, including the example using how to use in the AT&T M2X cloud to exchange data between the between our platform and the cloud. And also we will share where developers could find the most resources on our website. So what is LinkIt? LinkIt is a wearable IoT development platform. MediaTek creates this platform to accelerate the wearable and IoT development and this market. And LinkIt is based on the Astra chipset, which is MT2502. It's the smallest chipset on the market for the wearables. The size of the 2502 is 5.4 by 6.2 by 1 millimeters. And also, we have companion chipsets for Wi-Fi and GPS. So with those companion chipsets, and also the Aster, you can have all sorts of connectivities to the networks. The LinkIt is a hardware, LinkIt ONE is a, LinkIt is a hardware and software development platform for wearable and IoT. It consists of four blocks. First of all is a system on chip, we call it SoC. It's an Aster 2502 and with companion chipsets. Plus the LinkIt OS, which is OS specifically developed for this platform. And also we have a hardware toolkit. It's called HDK. And the HDK is developed by State Studio. State Studio is our partner and who uses MediaTek's reference design to create the hardware for this platform. And the fourth part is a LinkIt SDK, which is a SDK specifically developed for this platform. For this release one, we have the SDK for Ardunio. Ardunio is a very popular development platform in the market for the makers. The makers, most of the makers are very familiarized with the Ardunio IDE. So that's the reason we have this SDK created for the Ardunio. So they have make it easier for the makers start to adapt the LinkIt platform. Next, we will cover what is the LinkIt ONE HDK. We will go over the hardware specifications and designs, etc. So this is the front view of the hardware board we call the LinkIt, made by the State Studio. From the diagram, you can see it's an Arduino compatible layout, and you can have the Arduino Uno shield plug on top of this board. This board consists of a number of outputs, inputs. That we have a GUIP, it's a general purpose I/O on the top. There are 16 GUIPs. On the bottom, we have a power out as well as AD converters and some of the GUIPs on the bottom as well. And on the right side, you can see there is a SPI, SPI connector. SPI means serial peripheral interface, which allows you to connect other peripherals which comply with the SPI interfaces, such as the displays and also some other serial devices, yeah, if you like. And also in the middle, there are two white sockets. Those are the SAIDs, growth system. It's a four-wire socket, so you can use the growth system to plug in any growth-compatible sensors, as well as you can extend those two growth interfaces into 16 with the extender board. On the left side, we have three jacks, the headphone jacks, the USB jacks, and also the battery jack. So you can have a headphone and listen to the MP3 AAC played out through this development board. Also, you can use USB to charge the battery as well as supply powers. And also, the battery jack allows you to connect the lithium battery to this board. So you can run software on this board solely with the power from the battery. And also on the bottom, there is a reset button, yeah, for convenience. So if you need to reset the board, you press that button. And also there are three switches. The central one is the SD and slash spy switch, which allows you to control whether to access the onboard SD cards or to allow the use of the spy interface. If the switch on the top, yeah, which allows you to use the SPI interface, SPI interface on the right. If the switch is on the bottom, allows you to access the SD, allows the software to access the SD cards. The SD card we were going to show you is on the bottom of this board. And also, there are two switches on the right as well. A mass storage slash normal mode switch. This switch allows you to either access the onboard flash and SD card, or run the software, the sketch software normally. So if the switch is on the top, which allows you to access the mass storage on the bottom, the board will run the sketches normally. The third switch is a battery, USB slash battery power switch, allows you to choose the supply of the power either from battery or from the USB. So this is a back view or bottom view of this board. From this board, you can see we have three antenna connectors on the left. The top one is the connector to the GPS, or GLONASS. The middle one is the Wi-Fi Bluetooth. They share the same connector. And the bottom is the connector for the GSM. And on the right side, you see there is a combo slot, yeah, which allows you to either insert a SIM card or SD cards. And there are three main chipsets. The one on the right is the Astra chipset. That's the main processor on this board. This chipset contains the Bluetooth, GSM, and the GPRS baseband. The other two chipsets on the left, the top one is the GNSS. It's a GPS chipset combined with GPS, GLONASS, and Beidou. By default, the system operates on the GPS slash GLONASS. The one in the middle is a Wi-Fi chipset. This is the overall view of this board with three antennas connected. Those antennas come with this board. So when you purchase or acquire the development board, you will get all those three antennas. Let's go over some like hardware specifications of the HDK. The microcontroller is a MT2502A, the Aster. It's a ARM-based architecture, ARM7, runs on the 260 megahertz. And also the PCB size is 3.3 by 2.1 inches. We have memory. The memory is built on the board. It's an external of the SOC. It's 16 megabytes. And also we have RAMs on the SOC. It's 4 megabytes. The power supply, as we said in the earlier, we could have two power supplies. We could choose either battery or USB. USB not only supply power, also charging the batteries. And also we have IOs, we call it GPIO, General Purpose IO, 16 IOs. And also we have analog inputs. There are three analog inputs ranging from 0 to 5 volts. And also we have the PWM, pulse width modulation. We have two sets with different resolutions. And also we on the board, we got the external interrupts. Those are those interrupts through those two pins of the D2 and D3. So we could use the general purpose IO to D2 and D3 to trigger the interrupts. We also have I2C interface. We have one set of I2C interface, which is master only. And also the SPI interface is a one set master only as well. And we have two UART interfaces. One UART interface is on the USB, which is mapped to the serial object. Serial object is the one you could use to output the debug information on the serial monitor. And also the other UART interface is mapped to the serial one object. Now we have some, on the left side, we see those features. Built specific for the LinkIt ONE, GSM GPRS, as we said, because we have those GMS GPRS baseband integrated on the SOC 2502, that's why we have those quad band GSM. And also supports the GPRS class 12. And also we have Bluetooth base rate with enhanced data rate as well as Bluetooth low energy. And also we support Wi-Fi BNG standards with max of the 150 megabits per second. For the GPS, we support the GPS, GLONASS, and Beidou. Default is GPS, GLONASS. And for the user storage, we have flash and also SD card. SD card can up to 22 gigabytes with class 10. So this is a LinkIt ONE HDK in the box. So when you can purchase it through the State Studio .com/LinkIt ONE, and you get everything. Yeah, you see here. One thing is missing here is a lithium battery. So the battery comes with this box as well. Besides this developer board, State Studio also provides a range of sensors for the developer to use. They package them into a box called the Grove Starter Kit for LinkIt ONE. They all come with the standard Grove interface. So from the diagram, you can see those Grove interface, which is compatible to the ones on the HDK board. So you connect them through the cable. The cable comes with those box as well. So you can find this start kit on the State Studio website as well. So what is the Grove interface? So this diagram shows you how Grove works. So Grove is kind of a state-defined interface, and they make it modularized. So each sensor share the same interface, so you can plug in, and you can also have an extender board to extend the two onboard Grove interfaces into 16. So you can plug it, virtually you can plug in 16 different sensors for your application. And all the sensors you can find with the Grove interface through the State Studio website. Now let's get to the software. Yeah, that supports the development for the wearables and IoT with this HDK. So LinkIt ONE software development kit is actually, as I mentioned earlier, is an extension of the Arduino IDE. which is a plugin to the Ardunio IDE. Later on, we will go over how we are going to install the SDK. So this is this show you the flow, how we use this SDK to develop our applications or prototyping our applications. First of all, we need to download the Arduino, install our Arduino, and then go to the labs.media.com website to download the SDK and install the SDK. When you launch the SDK installation, you are allowed to choose the root folder where you install the Arduino, right? From the here, you can see the Arduino is installed in the on the D drive, D/Arduino, so that's the root folder. Once you have that selected, so you run the installation of the SDK, and then once complete, you launch the Arduino, and you will find the LinkIt ONE showing on the Arduino environment through the tools and the board. So here you select the board as LinkIt ONE, and then you can start to run your sketch. You know, Arduino calls a program or application as a sketch. And you can load the sketch onto the board by clicking on the right arrow, and the application will run on the board. So that's the flow, how you use this environment. So what we need to do now, yeah, we need to first download and install the latest the Windows version of the Arduino IDE, which can be found it's the Arduino website, http://arduino.cc. And for example, you can get the 1.5.7 Windows compatible installation. Here, I just want to mention it. The first release, LinkIt ONE SDK, supports Windows operating system only. Yeah, we are working on to provide the versions to support iOS and Android as well. So after you install the download the Arduino installation executable, yeah, you could go to our site to download the LinkIt ONE SDK. So here you can find the LinkIt ONE SDK through the link. And the current version we offered on our website is 1.0.38. And then you follow the process to install it. First of all, you install the Arduino, and you choose your favorite folder where you want to install the Arduino, and then launch the execution of the LinkIt ONE SDK executable. You will be prompted to select the root folder for the Arduino. Here, on the screen you can see, and you can choose the C/program/Arduino folder. That's where the Arduino executable resides. So once you choose that folder, and the installation software of SDK will extract all the necessary files and put them into the right place for you. Once that's done, you can launch the Arduino environment, right? So when you launch the Arduino environment, you will see an environment ID like this. And what you need to do, the first is you need to go to the tools, boards, and then select the LinkIt ONE for debug, right? And that information will also show on the bottom of the Arduino IDE here. And also, I would like you to check the device manager for those two USBs, for those USB drivers we installed through the installation. This is quite crucial. The reason I want to show you because a lot of developers might be confused by those two ports. So after the installation, you can plug in your board through the USB cable onto your computer. And if you go to the Windows Device Manager, you would see those two USB ports listed under the ports. So one is the USB debug port. The other one is the USB modem port. Those two ports are quite important. The debug port, remember here it shows COM port 1. The debugger port is used, has to be selected on the Arduino environment for upload sketch onto the board. The modem port which is COM port 6 in this case, either one has to be selected in that environment in order to get the output to the serial monitor. So we will mention this later as well. So once you've done that, so how can I make sure my installation was done successfully? You can run an example to verify if the installation was done completely or not. So what you could do is open the Arduino environment through the file examples, basically choose the Blink example. That will load the Blink sketch into the environment. And then in the under the tool manual, so tool port, you need to select COM port 5. Remember, in the earlier slide, COM port 5 is the debugger port. So once you select this one, debugger port, you are able to upload the sketch onto the board by clicking the right arrow. So once you click on the right arrow, the software, the sketch will be loaded onto the hardware board and start to run. You would see one LED will blink once every second. So once you see the example of the blink works this way, which indicates your installation is done properly and completely. So now I would like to give you a little bit more of the insight of the SDK itself. You know, this SDK, this diagram shows the high-level architecture of the SDK. So we have a hardware on top of that is LinkIt OS, right? We release a LinkIt OS as a binary. And on top of the LinkIt OS, we have Arduino port layer. This port layer is released as a source code. So you can actually see the header file and the CPP files in the source code. And with those three layers of software, you would be able to build your own Arduino sketch. Inside the LinkIt OS, what we have is the, first of all, is the embedded OS. The embedded OS is a nucleus OS. And we have drivers for the Aster, as well as GPS and Wi-Fi. So those GPS and Wi-Fi, they are the companion chipsets, and those three chipsets are built onto the board. So we have the drivers for three of them. And then we have a middleware protocol, we have the frameworks, and on top of them is a LinkIt runtime environment. There are some features in the SDK, because we said the SDK itself is an extension to the Arduino. That's why the SDK itself inherits a lot of Arduino functions, such as those listed on the right side, digital I/O, pulse shift, analog input, serial, time and delay, interrupts, mass servo, stepper, spy, and I2C. The functions on the right side, those are the functions specifically provided through the SDK of the LinkIt. And in the libraries, you would see those functions are preceded with the letter L. L means LinkIt. So you would say LGPS, actually it's a GPS module, but however, is built specifically for the LinkIt. So in the LinkIt SDK, we have GSM. GSM supports the SMS, and also the GPRS. GPRS, right now we support the TCP and the UDP socket. Wi-Fi supports the TCP UDP socket too, and Bluetooth, the current release supports the SPP, serial port, port profile, and we are working on the support for the GATT, which is going to be available soon. And the GPS, of course, we support the linear format, and the audio supports the MP3 as well as the ACC formats. And the SD card and the flash, we support the FAT33 formats. So those are the major features and as well as we have EE Prom. So those are the major features, functions provided through the LinkIt ONE SDK. So now let's get some example so that we can start to exercise and use this environment. There are a lot of examples you can use. If you go to the file examples, you would see many examples come with this SDK installation. And those ones I would like to highlight here is those ones provide the specific for the LinkIt SDK, starting with letter air, air audio, air battery, air BT, etc. So you can go to each folder to grab whatever sample code you want to run from the examples. Now I would like to show you how to use the LinkIt board with barometer sensors through the Bluetooth to communicate with the AT&T M2X cloud to exchange data. So what we have here now is a hardware board, LinkIt ONE SDK with Wi-Fi antenna and state groove parameter sensors. That's how they connected, right? We need to do some preparations in order to run this example. First of all, we need to get software. You can go to the AT&T website to download and import the M2X stream client library into the Arduino environment. I give this link here. And also, you can go to the SIGS Studio website, the GitHub, to download the libraries for the parameter sensors from that link below. Once you import those libraries into the Arduino environment, you can start to write your sketch. This is a snippet of the sketch I'm showing here. And on the line 18 to line 21, you can see those are the JSON lines that comes from the AT&T M2X library and also the M2X stream clients as well. And also the parameter .h is imported through the parameter library from the SIGS Studio. What you need to do is now to first specify your AP, the name of your Wi-Fi, and also the password, as well as the security mode that we are using, the WPA security mode. And also, you need to find out your fate ID through the M2X cloud. Yeah, when you register with the cloud service through the AT&T, you will get the fate ID and streaming name and also the API key. Those three things listed here. And the streaming name you define yourself. For this example, I define as the temperature. I want to exchange the temperature, upload the temperature onto the cloud. So I define the four variables here. Now it gets to the setup. If you are familiarized with Arduino, you know that there are two functions in the Arduino sketch. They are the key functions. One, first is setup. Second is the loop. Loop runs continuously, non-stop. So we usually do the setup for the, we usually do the initialization inside the setup. So what we did here is we initialize the L task, L Wi-Fi, and also we initialize my parameter. We call those three functions, and then we set up the board read for the serial output. And on 944, I use a while loop to stop at the this line until we have the serial monitor opened through Arduino. So program doesn't move further until we open up the serial monitor. So that way we can get the full logs. On the line 48, you can see that's how we are connecting to the Wi-Fi through this statement. It's very easy. You just call the lwifi.connect with the security mode and also your login information. And on the line 54, we print out the status of the Wi-Fi. Those are pretty straightforward. And this is a routine, what information we print out through the, for the Wi-Fi connection. We print out the names of the Wi-Fi and also the signal strings, IP address, etc. So here, this loop does the data collection through the sensors. So first on the line 62, you can see we read the output from the barometer sensor and specifically for the temperatures. So we call this library. This library comes with the library we imported through the CStudio GitHub into the Arduino. And we can also get other parameters as well, like a pressure, altitude as well. So I only want to let you know we are going to upload the temperature to the cloud. We just leave the pressure and altitude, et cetera, locally printed out in the environment. So from line 69 to 73, we print out the parameters. And 76, that's the line we use to exchange data to the M2X cloud. We call this M2X client.put and passing the feed ID, the stream name, and also the temperature value. So with one simple statement, the data is sent up to the cloud, to the AT&T cloud. And later on, you can see the results. So this shows the results, and the diagram on the bottom is a screen capture of the data that we send to the cloud once every 5 seconds. So you would see those values, you know, temperatures, quite consistent, yeah, that's the room temperature. On the right side, this diagram shows whatever been printed out through the serial print in the Arduino environment. Okay, so after we went through the examples, and I would like to show you where you can get those resources on our website. We have a lot of resources for developers. First of all, the hardware reference design, you can get the pinout diagram, the layout, and the schematics, and also the chipsets, the technical briefs on our website. As long as you register with us, you can get all of them free of charge. And also, you will get a software developer guide, which tells you how to use this SDK, include the installations and the details, step-by-step instructions. And also you get the API reference manual as well. And also, if you have additional questions, you can find the answers on the discussion forum. It's a very active discussion forum and updated every day. And in addition, we have a FAQ as well. So that's where you can get the common questions answered. And with those links, yeah, you can easily find those resources on our website through forum, contact us, or email. So we are here and try to do our whatever we can to help developers to use the LinkIt SDK for their wearable and IoT development. So that's the end of my presentation. I would like to open the floor for some questions if you would like, if you
We do, sorry, Stephen, I muted you on accident. We do have a few questions. I can read them out for you. One of them says, will an HSPA Plus or LTE version be available in the near future?
Yes, we are working on. We believe that will be available in the future.
Yeah, it says in the near future. The next question is, are there sensors that will work with NFC tags?
With what tag? Those sensors work with the groove interface. Of course, you can find the sensors from other suppliers as long as they either comply with the groove interface or comply with the SPI interface. And also we have A2D converter. So some sensors may have some like a A2D interface as well. So we can do the analog to digital inputs through the through those interfaces.
And it looks like the last one is, do you help support all join and what security support do you have? I guess it's two questions.
Andrea, could you repeat the question again?
Do you help support all join was the first one.
support all join.
All join.
Or support Android?
It's actually, if you want to open your Q&A panel, it's called all join.
Oh, unfortunately, somehow I don't see the Webex window here.
If you go up to the top of your screen, a little bar will drop there.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
And the other question is, what security support do you have?
Yeah, that's a good question. The first release, we don't have a security in our first release yet, but we are going to add that in our later release.
Perfect. I don't see any other questions. We did get a question, will this be recorded? And it will be recorded and posted to our AT&T Developer Program YouTube page, which is youtube.com/ATTDev. So we will have this available later. And he has all the technical information or the contact information that you need on the screen now. So if you do have any questions, just feel free to reach out to them in those three different ways. So thank you, Stephen, for giving us an overview of the LinkIt platform, and hopefully this will help some of you that are going to attend the AT&T Developer Summit Hackathon and Conference. This presentation and all of our other Bootstrap Week presentations will be made available later this week on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/attdev, as well as our AT&T Developer Program blog at developer.att.com. Thank you, everyone, for participating in this Bootstrap Week event. If you're interested in other sessions, please see our WebEx page, which is at attdeveloper.webex.com. Thanks for joining, and we'll see you soon.